Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the battery, optical drive, and rear corner covers. Removal. Remove the Mylar screw cover from the base enclosure. Remove the 16 6.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the top cover to the base enclosure. Remove the two 4.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the top cover to the base enclosure. Remove the two 2.5mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws from the optical drive bay that secures the top cover to the base enclosure. Turn the notebook over and open the display panel. Carefully separate the edges of the top cover from the base enclosure. Lift the front edge of the top cover until you have access to the touchpad board ZIF connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the fingerprint reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the fingerprint reader board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard light ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard light ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the power button board ZIF connector and disconnect the power button board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the top cover. Replacement. Note: before installing a new top cover, remove the following from the old top cover and install onto the new top cover: power button board, touchpad board, fingerprint reader board. Place the top cover into position on the base enclosure so that you have access to the keyboard, touchpad board, fingerprint reader board, keyboard light, and power button board ZIF connectors on the system board. Insert the power button board ribbon cable into the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the keyboard light ribbon cable into the keyboard light ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the fingerprint reader board ribbon cable into the fingerprint reader board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the keyboard ribbon cable into the keyboard ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the touchpad board ribbon cable into the touchpad board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Apply pressure to the edges of the top cover to snap it into place. Close the display panel and turn the notebook over. Replace the two 2.5mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the top cover to the base enclosure. Replace the two 4.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the top cover to the base enclosure. Replace the 16 6.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the top cover to the base enclosure. Replace the Mylar screw cover onto the base enclosure.